accidentally deleting the audio for your clip is one of the worst things. If you select a clip though and you hit F, the source media is gonna pop up with the portion that you're looking for marked out. Simply just pull down the audio from the source and there it is. When it comes to the flow of your video, timing is crucial. The trim tool allows you to really get precise with the timing of your clips. So if you drag the upper part of your clip, it's gonna adjust the timing of it while keeping the overall length the same. On the bottom part, your clip next to it is gonna be extending instead of the clip that you're dragging around. Now the dreaded media offline is something that we've all encountered before. All you need to do is right click on your media pool and go down to relink clips for bin. Then tell Resolve where the files are. Odds are that's gonna take care of your issue. However, if you still have a missing media, right click on the offline clip and select open file location. All you gotta do is find it and relink it. Now if your timeline is slugging along, make sure they have render cache on. Go up to playback, render cache, and then select either smart or user. Smart will automatically cache stuff for you, while user mode will rely on you to tell it what to cache. To do that, you'll need to right click and select render cache fusion output on each clip. If you've had a failed rendering job, it can be frustrating, but if this is happening to you, pay attention to the clip that causes this error. Now find the clip in the edit tab, right click on it, select render in place, and then select the proxy settings. Now let it render. Assuming that this was the only problem to clip, try exporting your project again and it should work. If you're on the color page and you need to add more inputs to your mixer nodes, right click on them and select add one input as many times as your heart desires. You can also remove an input like this as well. If you've had this weird frozen timeline glitch, all you have to do to fix it is to switch to the deliver page and then back to the edit page. This should refresh the timeline without having to restart the software. If you've ever wanted to add an effect like vignette to your whole video, you can just go to the color tab and switch from clip to timeline. Then hit Alt S to add a new node and add your effect. When you go back to the edit tab, everything on your timeline is gonna have the effect on it. Slow rendering speeds suck, especially if you end up needing to render out your video multiple times. If you know your effects are completely finished, render them in place. That way, when you go to export your project, your effects will already be rendered, which will save you time in the end. So to speed up the program, try mapping your cache folder to a second drive. This will need to be an SSD or an M.2 though. If not, you're gonna be running really slow. Mapping the cache to another fast drive is gonna allow faster overall speeds. And don't forget to clear that cache from time to time because that thing gets chunky. I'm also gonna drop a few
I almost said a few drinks.
I'll drop some alcohol in the comments below. Come get it. No, don't do that. So I'll drop a few of our favorite drives in the description for you. Anyway, we have more videos like this coming your way, so subscribe and turn on the bell so you don't miss out on any of them. Until the next one, peace.